Pisces, welcome to your general reading. My name's Clive, you're watching Emery's Tarot. It's a pleasure to be here as always. The only thing I have to say is please take the bits that resonate, leave the rest. Do not try to make it fit. You'll just end up with a wrong conclusion, okay? With that said, let's see what energies and messages the universe has for you. What messages does the universe have for the sign of Pisces? You have the Emperor, you have Temperance card, you have Six of Pentacles, you have the High Priestess, wow, Tower Moment, Ace of Pentacles, Nine of Wands, King of Wands, Ace of Swords, bonus card, Ace of Cups. Ooh, two aces, great. New starts on two new fronts. I'm kind of getting your mental attitude, Pisces, is becoming much more resolute, okay, especially about love. In fact, you've got the hat trick here, three aces. So there's like three areas of your life that are going to change irrevocably and forever. I'm kind of getting that your practical situation, there's an honest practical offer here of some kind for a lot of you. Okay, this could be in work, or it could be a new relationship or an invite, okay, which could lead to bigger things. On getting here, it's like a stepping stone. All right, then you've got the Ace of Swords, all right, making major decisions, but with true clarity. So your mental state is changing. There was a lot of confusion in the past. There was split loyalties, you know, and I'm kind of getting you were hanging on or self-sabotaging due to the fact that you couldn't make your mind up. But I'm kind of getting here that that time is coming to an end after a long struggle. And then, of course, as the bonus, you have this Ace of Cups. Now, what I'm getting here is friendships. All right, those that have been stretched or tainted, okay, they have the chance to resolve themselves. But there's one particular connection here where, you know, you feel somebody has wanted it their own way, and they've had it their own way for quite a while, okay? But what I'm getting here is you are taking more responsibility for yourself. You're not being led anymore. You're making your mind up about a certain person. We have a lot of Aries energy here, okay, with this King of Staves and this Emperor. All right, you're taking control of your life. You're beginning to see the bigger picture. You're beginning to see the consequences of your actions. I'm kind of getting here that, you know, where there were split loyalties, there's now clarity on who you want in your life, where you want to live, what work you want to do. Okay, and where there was codependency, I'm kind of getting that is also diminishing. You're very, very focused at the moment. Okay, and even if you're not, you soon will be. I'm kind of getting that as on yourself. There is one particular connection here. I'm getting Aries energy, but I'm also getting Sagittarius energy. So you could be dealing with two fire signs, but possibly one where there is some Sagittarius and Aries in them. All right, you feel this person has had it their own way too long. It's kind of like there's a lot of realization. There's a wake-up call here with this Tower moment. All right, you're starting to, instead of being led, you're starting to be the leader. All right, this Tower moment, you're going to be the one to instigate it. So whatever that Tower means to you, a complete collapse, a complete severance, a complete separation, a change of job, setting out on your own, whatever, that is you. That Tower, you're going to one that's going to instigate it, because you're getting your truth and clarity now. This person seems to be afraid of commitment the way you see it. And you feel also there's some trust issues here. You feel there's secrets. Okay, some of you, this is not for all of you, but for some of you. And you've possibly been dating and struggling with somebody for a fair while, but then somebody new comes on the scene. Much more sensitive, very, very different from this person. Okay. And there is irrevocable change in your attitude. there has been sudden changes, partly out of your control, which you've kind of worried about. But, you know, I came to the conclusion in life to try and stop worrying about the things I can't control and concentrate on the things I can, i.e. my reactions, the way I handle things. All right. Now, with this emperor here, this person does want to perhaps take the relationship to the next level. But I'm kind of getting you're not so sure. There has been a long history here with somebody. All right. And this, it has been a very fleeting in and out. There's been some hurt. There's been conversations. There's been tempers fray. All right. But yeah, what I'm getting here is you're the one taking control of this. It's like in the past, people did you a favour. They was expecting things in return, ulterior motives, etc., etc. With this new clarity that's coming in, this new clear vision of yours in your mind of what you want and who you want, I'm kind of getting there's going to be more than one separation here for some of you. You know, fair weather friends, work colleagues who depend on you. All right. I'm getting in the past that you've been kind of too quick to jump in, too quick to help. Now you're thinking about the bigger picture and the consequences of those actions. Right. Why is this emperor here? Two of wands. Yeah, stepping outside the comfort zone. There has been kind of an energy around you at the moment where the situation where somebody keeps changing their mind. It's like they keep coming forward, then retracting. This could be you, could be the person you're dealing with. But it's the energy around this two of wands on getting is making plans and actually being prepared to follow them through. I'm getting here for one or two of you. This could be due to stepping out into the world in a new career, working for your own, expansion of your own business, or even just plain changing jobs and taking one with more responsibility. But either way, in a career, it looks like your career is going to change, or at least the energy is there to give you the chance to change it. It's a question of, you know, overcoming any fears, overcoming any fear of commitment. You know, whatever the situation is in your life, whether this is a personal love situation, family situation, there is a fear here, a bit of overcommitting, and this self-image that you've got. Am I actually capable? Yes, you are. All right, why is this temperance here, please? Pisces, you're more than capable. It's just application. Devil, yeah. You could be dealing with somebody with narcissistic tendencies or an addiction to something, but here there's, or you feel somebody's taking advantage of you, they're not interested in, you know, taking the relationship. It's a very, very shallow relationship. Okay. I'm kind of getting the person that you're dealing with perhaps has a lot of inhibitions, all right, very self-conscious. But you, I'm kind of getting you're actually dropping inhibitions. You're doing the opposite. You're overcoming your fears. Why is this Six of Pentacles here? Whatever's been holding you back, I'm getting you releasing it. Fresh start. Requires that leap of faith, that belief in yourself. I'm getting you're in the mood to travel, whether that's temporarily or permanently, but you're in the mood for movement. You're tired of stagnation, you're tired of codependency, you're tired of things not going your way. There's a lot changing about you, Pisces. Very big deal. There could be after a separation here, somebody wants to come back into your life, but either way you're very, very reserved, although it could well take you by surprise. Three of Wands, yeah, somebody who's been procrastinating is now going to start to act. Okay, this Three of Wands is all about taking action. But there's still a lot of inhibitions to overcome. Why is this tower here? You can expect delays in your plans, but if you keep plodding in and make compromises and keep going, finish what you start, carry it through, then I'm kind of getting it will lead eventually to success, whatever endeavor you're about to embark on. This tower here, Six of Swords, yeah. There's a situation here that is literally going to finish because it wasn't stable in the first place. All right. And you're dictating. You're being the catalyst. I'm kind of getting you're going to move on. There is a separation here which will lead to healing. This Ace of Pentacles. Why is it here, please? Yeah. A lot more communication. The world's at your feet now. Travel, new opportunities. But to achieve your ambitions and dreams, it is you've got to make up your mind and know what it is exactly, what is what you want. All right, I'm kind of getting there was a bit of indecision here. Once you know what it is you actually want, that's when your clarity comes in, that's when you can strive and focus. Okay, you've got the Nine of Wands here. Yes, of course, it will come in with challenges, but it's also a question of following your heart's desire. Like I say, I'm kind of getting here on the relationships front. There's a new offer. Somebody's revealing their feelings. There's been a fear of rejection. King of Wands. Sun card. Yeah, happiness. Wow, relationships sorting themselves out. I'm kind of getting to, you know, without being forced, there's a person you're dealing with, they'll come forward if you leave them alone. Ace of Swords, Six of Wands, yeah, success here, focus, strength, tenacity, it's all yours for the up for the grabs. Ace of Cups. Yeah, Page of Cups, be open to change, be open to anything because there's something new. I'm kind of getting it's going to be something you don't expect. Okay. But the perspective, the realistic attitude now is coming to the fore with you. I'm kind of getting that because of the changes going on within you, because of external circumstances, there is this attitude of seeing things much more realistically. I'm going to leave it there. Thanks very much for watching.